Kadri to start, along with Zeri and Uyghur. Red Wings have the puck. Larkin, Raymond, and Sider. Raymond, off ice, cuts wide, curls to the line, turned it over. Uyghur springs Kadri. Kadri coming in one-on-one on Sider. And he'll go out of the zone for a reset.
Smart play by Kadri. He shoots that. He doesn't have numbers with him. It would have been a giveaway. Now they regroup.
Kadri across the Detroit line. Kadri coming in overtime. Spins, shoots a backhander. Stopped by Talbot off a shifty move from Nazem Kadri.
There's Jonathan Huberto over the boards, along with Sharon Goldberg. A bit of a high-risk play, as either one are not great defensively. Sharon Govich perhaps a little better. And then you got Anderson, who likes to fly up the ice as well. So Coach Huska here going for it a bit.
Sharon Govich trying to start with the puck. Does win it. Huberto doesn't shoot. Between the legs, behind the back pass, sends Anderson out of the Detroit zone. Yeah, high risk, maybe high reward. Sharon Govich in, shoots, and got all of that one, but off the stick of Edmondson, it stays out. Huberto had to help out defensively. Rasmus Anderson, oh boy, that was a difficult play to make on to Huberto one-on-one. Now has some help, find Sharon Govich, and at the last moment, Compher got a piece to knock it away. Sharon Govich in overtime, retreats back to Rasmus Anderson. Anderson, up ice with Huberto. Anderson curls around the Detroit net. Sharangovich back pedals. Flames changing. And the crowd getting on Calgary for taking their time here, but fresh legs on the ice in overtime. Uyghur missed that pass, and he's frustrated. Here come the Red Wings, and Raymond would have been, or pardon me, to break it would have been home free.
Ooh.
And they'll call that on the icing with a late whistle. After the turnover, the Flames realized almost too late that DeBrincat had a path into the zone.
Well, now they got a little more responsibility here on the ice with Backlund on the ice.
That's pretty close. I think DeBrincat was saying I was going
to
beat.
And they went to center ice with it.
Larkin ties up the stick of Backlund. Detroit with the puck in OT. Up ice is Sider. Oh, long in overtime. Shoots and missed.
How did he get that open?
It doesn't look any get any better than that. Flames trying to go back the other way.
He snuck right in behind everybody. Nobody saw him.
It's almost the same play DeBrincat was making before that icing. Raymond on the outside of Uyghur. Larkin. As Sider checks the clock, Flames live another day after Sider missed an overtime breakaway. Larkin drops back. Oh, Sider. 2:20 to go in the extra frame.
Flames need a change here badly.
Backlund. They get one off anyway.
Yep, Backlund to the bench. Kadri on. Red Wings moving the puck in quickly, but sent all the way back.
Now they get the other two off quickly, though. Ooh.
Kasper calling for it. Finds it. Michael Kasper in. Tried to play to Tarasenko. Turned over. And that's called. Anderson confused as the reason for the whistle here.
What do we got going here now? The linesman has made a call.
Too many men on the ice.
It was too many. I didn't think they were going to call that. And neither did Zeri.
The linesman called it. So there's the change. Two come off. Zeri's off. One, two, three, four. Wow. They're not going to like the log, the change, the cheat change, I guess. That's a tough call in overtime.
Yeah, the door's still open to the Flames penalty box, which shows you just a little bit more of the frustration. It's going to be 4-on-3 Detroit. Taking his time
here. There was no possession made on the change, so like I get it if there was a possession change and Flames ended up with the puck, but they didn't. But they didn't like the change of being cheating, and every team cheats like that, but never gets called.
Calgary trying to dig deep. Red Wings power play in overtime. Have the power play goal this game from DeBrincat. Sider taking his time. Up top, Raven. Down low, Larkin. Off the leg of Anderson. Stays out. Sider on to Raven. 4-on-3 in overtime. Sider to DeBrincat. Cross crease looking for Larkin's redirection. Raven shoots, scores. Short for the Flames as Rasmus Anderson gives a thumbs up to the refs. A frustrating end for Calgary and Dan Vladar.
And that was the linesman that made the call, too. And the Flames react accordingly on the way off the ice.
Too many men on the ice call finishes what could have been an exciting end to this one. And the Flames have not finished sharing their thoughts with the officials as they head to the dressing room. Lucas Raymond, sixth career overtime winner.
Well, we'll show you the call again. I mean, you be the judge. I mean, yeah, there was a lot of players on the ice, for sure. And here's the penalty, so they're going off. It allowed the Flames to get back into defensive position. But nevertheless, I mean, it's a call you just don't see, to be quite honest with you, very often. And they called it. Was it too many men by the rules? You could say it was. Do they call that very often? Not very often.
Well, Calgary does get a point out of this, but...